Today is the second day of the Stockholm Fashion Week. And this year is the first year ever for the big brands Filippa K and Acne to participate in the Stockholm Fashion Week. And we're going to meet Rasmus at Filippa K and Acne Jonny to hear what they have to say about their new collections.
For this season, we worked with a bullfighting team. It's a female famous bullfighter called Juanita Cruz, and she was kind of setting the mood for the whole collection. On the men's side, it was more of an ethnic exploration. Por el camino del desierto, el viento me despeina, sueva aroma de colita, nada, nada. This is creative collective with a lot of people working on the same roof. So I think our collection comes out differently every time. This is on things that we use a lot. It's a lot of old Vogues, Italian Vogues, some French Vogue. There's one from 83 and 74. And then also these special numbers where they did in French Vogue, which was very interesting. With could be an artist that flavor the whole issue, which these are, of course, fantastic, very inspirational.
But Acne has had a tremendous success, I'd say, recently internationally. And I think it's one of those bands that actually fashion insiders like. And they see as a fashion-y jeans brand, and a very cool jeans brand. They've done a fantastic job with Acne Paper, which I think is borrowing from something much more glamorous than the brand really is. But they are very good. They're very talented at what they're doing, and they've packaged it very well.
Right now you're under the preparations for the big Filippa K show, and how is that going?
Well, it's stressful, hectic, and nerve-wracking in a way. Shows are so much a large part of what fashion is all about, and so the only opportunity you get to do something that is slightly more artistic and sort of interesting from a fashion point of view.
Rasmus Wingårdh is now the new creative director, chief designer for Filippa K, and I think that's a very good choice because he's been taking care of the menswear before, and I think he's done a fantastic job.
Tell me about the collection.
Sort of inspired by some 70s subtle punk things, like which is, I mean, not, I'm not talking about studs and safety pins and stuff like that, but it's more like these sort of subtle things, like take Velvet Underground, for example, when Nico were the sort of lead singer. She was very girly dressed, and it was like, it was not really the stereotypical kind of punky.
I love her style, she's so inspiring.
The menswear, we sort of ended up with, yeah, it's this. Well, actually, it kind of works for both ladies and menswear, but it's like this sort of young lord in the countryside experiencing punk for the first time. When I was young, I went to boarding school, and that was kind of, we had like dress codes and stuff like that. But you sort of took these clothes that you were forced to wear, but you wore them in a sort of a slightly rebellic way.
Well, I think Acne and Filippa K sort of represents the what Swedish fashion is, the traditional simple design of Filippa K to the more jeans-based design that Sweden's becoming renowned for now. So I think that's for the mainstream fashion, which I suppose it is, I think they are very good representatives.
That's all from us at GoSee. Tomorrow there will be a lot more from the runways, and we will also visit Plus 46. And if you don't know what that is, check us out tomorrow.